Hello children, in the previous session of mathematics, we were discussing on the lesson areas of parallelograms and triangles. We learned about the parallelogram, its properties and a theorem based on it. As well as we also learned that how to identify the congruent figures. Till now we studied that only if two figures are of same shape and same size, then they are said to be congruent to each other. But we learn one more point added to that. That is, if at all their areas are equal, then also we say they are congruent to each other. Here we are mainly studying about the areas of the parallelograms and the triangles, which are standing on the same base and between the same parallels. So to understand this, we also saw in the first exercise of this lesson, exercise 11.1. Hope you have gone through it and understood it as well. And we learned the theorem, that is the very first theorem of this lesson, 11.1, which states that if at all two parallelograms are standing on the same base and between the same parallels, then their areas are equal. So we proved the theorem as well. With that background, children, today we shall be starting with the second exercise of this lesson, that is exercise 11.2. And up to this exercise, you will be having for your upcoming FA3. First question is, in the figure, ABCD is a parallelogram, AE is perpendicular to CD and CF is perpendicular to AD. If AB is equal to 16 cm, AE is 8 cm and CF is 10 cm, find AD is the question. So here is the given figure, ABCD is a parallelogram. So as soon as you see the parallelogram, children, you should recall its properties as well. Here AB and CD are opposite sides which are equal and parallel. Similarly, sides AD and BC of the parallelogram are also equal and parallel to each other. Now, from the vertex A of the parallelogram, a perpendicular is drawn to the side CD of the parallelogram, which it meets or intersects at point E. So, as we all know that perpendicular, what angles it makes? It makes, of course, the 90 degree. So, angle E 90 degree we have marked. Similarly, for the side AD also, a perpendicular CF is drawn. So, angle F is again 90 degree. CF is perpendicular to AD, AE is perpendicular to CD. And they have given these measurements as well. That is, side AB is 16 cm. Side AE, side anokinta, we say AE height AE. Why? Because it is the what we say is the perpendicular drawn, no? So we will take it or measure it as the height. So A height AE is 8 cm. Similarly, one more perpendicular CF is 10 cm. And what is, all the three measurements are given. What is the question is, find the measurement of AD. This side AD idhila, what is AD is equal to, we need to prove. The problems are very simple. If at all you have understood the theorem and few concepts which were discussed earlier. Now, we should write the given data as always. So, I have written all the measurements given. Along with that, you should describe the figure as well. In the figure, ABCD is a parallelogram. Now, the area of this parallelogram. Here, if you see, children, two altitudes are what the perpendiculars are drawn here, which are they? AE and CF. In order to find AD, how do we consider is, first we shall consider this whole parallelogram ABCD, and we will consider this parallelogram ABCD once with CD as base and once with AD as the base. Parallelogram ABCD means it is not always like how if a figure is given like this, always CD only you should consider as base. There is no such rule. Since we need to find out what is this side AD, we have to find out something with regard to the side AD itself. That is the reason what we do is, we will consider this whole parallelogram ABCD twice. with CD as base as well as with AD as base. How? I will explain now. Area of ABCD with BC or CD as base, Tomandra children. What is the area given by? It is nothing but simply the base into height. Here I have only explained, I mean it is given, we have chosen CD to be the base andre. In place of base we shall substitute CD. What is height now? If I am considering this side CD as the base, then this perpendicular should be taken. And how do you get hint in such problems to solve andre? Two perpendiculars are drawn, they have given. Which are they? AE one perpendicular to the side CD. CF is one perpendicular to the side AD. It is understood there is some hint there. So ECF perpendicular when we use the data, then we can easily find the unknown side, that is AD children. Like this you should try to analyze the problem. You should learn it. Now area. Area of ABCD when we consider. So this one sati base, idon sati base, and how do you decide? Because based on the hint given, which is the hint andra perpendiculars drawn anta mainly. So base into height. What is base now? When we have only said here CD is the base. Into what is the height? I said no. AE is not only perpendicular, but we also consider it as the height. So ABC into AE we will write. Now DC, so do we know the measurement of side CD or DC? No, we don't know. Do we know the measurement of height AE? Yes, we know, and it is equal to 8 cm. But children, since we know ABCD is a parallelogram, we know side AB is parallel to side CD as well as it is equal. So, since AB is 6 cm, CD no, we can take it as 16 cm itself. That one line you have to mention here. AB is equal to CD, which is equal to 16 cm. Reason, always you should state in the bracket. Why? Because they are the opposite sides of the parallelogram. Now, substitute. Base into height. Now, we will substitute in numbers and multiply. What is CD? 16 cm. AB, CD, 16. So, height AE or perpendicular AE is what? 8 cm. 16 into 8 when you do, you get 128 cm square as the area of this triangle, parallelogram ABCD. In the next case, if you find out similar way, here I don't know what is BC. If BC was given, our work was much easier. Why? Because BC equals AD and the ilmardange we would have done. But they have not given what is BC and what is AD. In that case, what we need to do is, we will take the help of this perpendicular. Now again we will consider area of parallelogram ABCD. What is the base now? With AD is the base. Just rotate the parallelogram. So AD base tagondaga, again same formula children, base into height. Here what is the base? AD is the base. What is the height? CF is the height. Andra AD into CF, that is what I have written here. Do we know what is CF? Yes, we know. It is equal to 10 cm. So, you can substitute. Do we know what is AD? No, we don't know. That is what we are finding out. But, two unknown quantities you cannot keep when you are finding out something. It is of no use, such data. What we need to do in that case is, just now we find out what is the area of parallelogram, isn't it? We are considering the same parallelogram with different base ashtay. So what we should do in that case, Andra, just know what we got 128 cm square as the area of parallelogram ABCD children, that 128 cm square, this area value I am substituting on the LHS is equal to AD into CF is 10 cm. So if 128 is equal to AD into 10, Andra, what is AD, Andra? It is clearly 128 divided by 10. When you do 128 divided by 10, you will get 12.8 cm square. Hence, we got what is the measurement of AD, and it is equal to, sorry, don't want centimeter square, this is side.